Nam, Dasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. The word Guru is derived from two words, Gu and Ru. The Sanskrit word Gu means darkness or ignorance, and Ru denotes the remover of that darkness. Gurus are believed to be the most necessary part of life. On this day, disciples offer puja, worship, or pay respect to their gurus.
Guru Purnima is celebrated on the full moon day of Ashada month. Guru Purnima is also known as Veda Purnima, Vyasa Purnima. And this day is commemorated as birth anniversary of Veda Vyasa, who was the author of great Hindu epic Mahabharata. Guru Purnima is also to honor Gautama Buddha for his first sermon at Sarnath, Uttar Pradesh. Guru is one who removes darkness of ignorance of the blinded and unenlightened by applying the medicines of spiritual knowledge. With the salutation unto the Holy Guru, let's begin our celebration.
And we would be privileged to invite our Sheila Didi for the Guru Stuti.
Mukam karoti vachalam
प्रार्थना व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय साय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे आय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मनिधये वै ब्रह्मनिधये वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः वशिष्ठनप्तारम् वशिष्ठनप्तारम् शक्तये पौत्रमकल्मषम् पौत्रमकल्मषम् शुकतातं तपोनितिम् गुरु भजन ओम गुरु ओम गुरु परात्परा गुरु ओम गुरु परात्परा गुरु ओंकारा गुरु तव शरणम् सुखकर दुखहर हे परमेश्वर
Sheila Didi. With this wonderful voice, let's carry on. And right now, it's the Guru Padaka Stotram. I invite Sri Surendra Kumar HS. And also, please request everyone to please join along with the prayer.
Shariram Surupam Tathava Kaladram Yashascharu Chitram Dhanam Meru Tulyam Manaschena Lagnam Gurorangri Padme Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Tatakim, tatakim, tatakim
Kalatram dhanam putra pautradi sarvam
Kalatram dhanam putra pautradi sarvam
Graham bandhava sarvamitadhi jatam
Graham bandhava sarvamitadhi jatam
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Shadangadi vedo mukhe shastra vidya
Shadangadi vedo mukhe shastra vidya
Kavitvadi gadyam supadyam karoti
Kavitvadi gadyam supadyam karoti
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Videsheshu manyasvadesheshu dhanyah
Videsheshu manyasvadesheshu dhanyah
Sadachara vritteshu matto na chanyah
Sadachara vritteshu matto na chanyah
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Shama mandale bhupa bhupala vrindai
Shama mandale bhupa bhupala vrindai
Sada sevitam yasya padaravindam
Sada sevitam yasya padaravindam
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Yasho megatam dikshu danapratapat
Yasho megatam dikshu danapratapat
Jagatvastu sarvam kareyat prasada
Jagatvastu sarvam karesat prasada
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim, tatah kim
Na bhoge na yoge na vavaji rajau
Na bhoge na yoge na vavaji rajau
Na kanta sukhe naiva vitteshu chittam
Na kanta sukhe naiva vitteshu chittam
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
Manaschena lagnam gurorangri padme
tata kim tata kim tata kim tata kim aranyena vasvasya gehena karye nadehe mano vartate me tvanarkhe
nadehe mano vartate me tvanarkhe
manaschena lagnam guru rangri padme
manaschena lagnam guru rangri padme
tata kim tata kim tata kim tata kim
tata kim tata kim
Gururashtakam yah pathet punya dehi
Gururashtakam yah pathet punya dehi
Yatirbhupatir brahmachari cha gehi
Yatirbhupatir brahmachari cha gehi
Labhetvanchitartham padam brahmasanyam
Labhetvanchitartham padam brahmasanyam
Gururuktavakye manoyasya lagnam
Gururuktavakye manoyasya lagnam
Gururuktavakye manoyasya lagnam
Gururuktavakye manoyasya lagnam
That mesmerizing voice and the chants. It's my privilege to invite our Honorable Registrar of S. Vyasa University to please take on the stage.
Nishesha Ambaratalam Yadipatrikasyat Saptarnavi Yadisameta Masi Bhavitri Vakta Sahasravadanaha Purushasvayam Chet Likheta Deshikaya Padukayor Prabhavaha. Once the Lord invited his beloved disciple and asked him to describe what is a guru and what is a guru mahima. So the disciple said, or the devotee said, please give me a paper so that I will write. And the Lord gave him a paper. He said, no, I need a paper as big as this sky. Nishesha Ambaratalam Yadipatrika Syat. Then he had to write, he required an ink. Then he said, give me the seven oceans. Saptar Navi Yadisameta Masi Bhavitri. Then after that, he said, now you write. I have given you the ink. I have given you the paper, now you write. He says, I need 1,000 tongues of Adi Shesha to speak about Guru Mahima. Vakta Sahasravadanaha Purushasvayam Chet. 1,000 tongues were also given. Now the devotee says, I cannot describe Guru Mahima. That is what is Guru Mahima today. Krishna, after he came back from Gokula, he went to Sandipini Ashram. And when he went to Sandipini Ashram, the guru started from alphabets. So he made him write Akara, A. And all the students there wrote Akara on their slate. So Sandipini Maharshi said, today you write over this. Tomorrow please erase this slate and come. And I will teach you Akara. These were the alphabets. So the next day, all the students had come with a clear slate. Krishna came back with the same akara on that. And Guru asked him, why Krishna, did you not follow my instructions? Why have you not erased? Krishna says, it's not getting erased. It's not getting erased. Then Sandipini Maharshi says, I will teach all the other people Akara and I will go for Madhyanika that time. Come with me. Madhyanika Sandhya, come with me and I will, we will see what happens. then Krishna and Sandipini Maharshi go to Yamuna Tira. When they go to Yamuna Tira, Sandipini Maharshi takes the holy water of Yamuna, sprinkles it on his head, keeps both his feet in Yamuna to give the Argya Pradana, and then asks for Krishna's slate. Krishna gives a slate with Akara written on that, which he had not erased. He takes the water of Yamuna, sprinkles on that, and erases it. He says, Krishna, you are lying. He said, no, Guruji, I am not lying. Even if the letters written with my own hand, I cannot erase it. But Guru Pada Dhuli can erase it. So Guru is higher than God. Whatever might be our karmas, which are written on our forehead, Vilupta Murdhyannilipikramanam Surendra Chudapadalalitanam Twadangri Rajiva Rajakkananam Bhuyan Prasado Mayinath Bhuyaha. A Guru's Padadhuli can change the fate, can erase all the negative vibrations inside us, can change our karma. Books, my dear friends, books gives us only information. Guru gives the dedication on the chosen subject. Welcoming the Supreme Guru who has occupied all our hearts, Anta Pravishta Shastha Jananam Sarvatma Sarva Karma Kartharam Yetat, let us most respectfully invite the Gurus of today to the dais. Guruji, kindly decorate the dais. Acharya Ji and our Honorable Vice Chancellor, a tribute to the Guru starts from today and would continue till this body is on this particular earth. And after that, so affectionately he holds our hand and takes us to the highest abode. Thank you so much.
Pranam Mohdaya. Next we have Guru Bhajan by Anakshi Didi.
invite the YIC students of 203 batch for the Pada Samarpanam to our respected gurus. Can we have a huge round of applause, please? With great respects and honor, on this occasion, we are also inclined to talk about one of the greatest gurus who showed the world that all are one and one for all, and instilled humanity at the most needed times in the history of mankind. It's none other than our honorable disciple of one of the greatest gurus, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, whose teachings shaped the future of a young man, and whose speech inspired millions in the 19th century at the Chicago World Religious Conference in 1893. It's none other than Swami Vivekananda, who proudly presented the world with his great knowledge and dedicated his works to his guru, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, where he said, "All that I am, all that the world itself will someday be, is owing to my master, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, who incarnated and experienced and taught this world unity which underlies everything, having discovered it alike in Hinduism, in Islam, and in Christianity." He also said, "If I have told you one word of truth, it was his and his alone. And if I have told many things which were not true, which were not correct, which were not beneficial to the human race, they will all be mine, and on me is the responsibility." Such was the greatness of Swami Vivekananda. And under the roots of whose teachings and knowledge lies the very foundation of our very own SPIASA University. Now, it's my privilege to invite our former Vice Chancellor and distinguished professor, Professor Ramachandra Bhatt, to stage for his wonderful speech. Thank you.
Vyasa is the real role model, Udatta Pankti, for all of us, yoga practitioners. Let us sit properly. Vyasa Prarthana, please recite. Krishna Dvaipayanam Vyasam. Krishna Dvaipayanam Vyasam Sarvaloka Hiteratam Vedanta Bhaskaram Vande Samadhi Nilayam Munim. We are all commuters, travelers of post-Vyasa period. Vyasa is not mere name given to call someone. The first Vyasa in our lineage, it was Marichi and Kashyapa, Atri, Bharadvaja, Vishwamitra, Gautama, Jamadagni, Vasishtha. These are all Saptarishis. They were called Vyasas. Even before these Prajapati Vyasa, these are called Saptarishis, there were four very close successors of Hiranyagarbha, Satyalokadhipati. They are called Sanaka, Sanat Kumar, Sanat Sujata, Sanandana, four. Vyasa and Janaka, these two words, not mere nomenclatures given to someone to call him. Those who were the greatest achievers, who could reach that pinnacle of jnana pramanya, cognitive clarity, they were called Vyasas. Those who could bring both Brahma and Kshatra, spiritual enlightenment and valor to protect nation, they are called Janakas. So these particular two streams of lineage started from very creation of this Vishwa, this wonderful world. Vishwa ki prachina dhara se behti hui pavana dhara, ganga dhara, jnana dhara, brahma dhara aur kshatra dhara, veera dhara, ye donon ka milap, that is the real balance of the swastha samaj, healthy society, sane society. Badarayana Vyasa, the contemporary of Vasudeva Krishna and Yajnaseni Draupadi Krishna, he was the greatest messenger, cultural messenger of Yuga Sandhi. Yuga Sandhi means Kali Dwapara Sandhi. There only he proclaimed, he gave a clarion call. Urdhva bahuhu viraumyeshaha nachakaschi chunoti me dharmad arthascha kamascha sakimartham nasevyate. He asked that society, contemporary society, prevailing society, highly puzzled society, where both artha and kama were dominating every sphere of society. Har manav ke man mein ye akand tandav mach raha tha, artha kama donon ka. To yah yuva samskritik pratinidhi yogi Badarayana Vyas gave that clarion call to bring dharma as the real basis for artha and kama. Please follow this. That is the message he gave. Now we are in this world, contemporary world, yoga mantra. Actually, Vyasa Maharshi lived yoga. He was an embodiment of yoga. Every inch, dhamani dhamani me, kana kana me, pal pal me, yehi ek yoga mantra chalta aya uske jivan dhara me. ऐसे व्यास हमारे आदर्श पुरुष, वह गुरु है. इसलिए वह गुरु है, वह मानसिक ग्रंथि से ऊपर रहा. माताजी उसकी सत्यवती ने बोला, ओ माय सन, बी हियर इन माय पैलेस. आई एम हियर राजमाता, आई कैन गिव शेल्टर, आई कैन अरेंज एयर कंडीशन प्रकोष्ठ फॉर यू फॉर कंफर्टेबल stay. Why should you roam here and there on the both banks of Saraswati river, protecting the Vedashakhas? So much tired. Be calm here. Take some relaxation. That is what mother telling. Vyasa told, mother, it is not my life message. I am not here for resting and for relaxation. If I go for relaxation, it will be collapse. I don't want collapse of dharma, collapse of vyakti samaja, ಕೊಲೆ ಸಬ್ ಸಮಗ್ರ ಭಾರತ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿ ಐ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ ಮೀ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸರ್ಚಿಂಗ್ ವೇದ ಶಾಖಾಸ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಗಂಗಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯಮುನಾ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಹೀ ಕುಡ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಹೀ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ 1,131 ಶಾಖಾಸ್ 21 ಶಾಖಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಋಗ್ವೇದ 101 ಶಾಖಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯಜುರ್ವೇದ 1,000 ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಚಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಾಮ 9 ಶಾಖಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಥರ್ವವೇದ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿಕ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಲೀನಿಯೇಜ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ರಿಷೀಸ್ ತಂ ವ್ಯಾಸಂ ಪ್ರಣಮಾಮಿ ಸಹ ವ್ಯಾಸ ಅಸ್ಮಾಕಂ ಅತ್ರ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ನ ವ್ಯಾಸ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ಮಂತ್ರ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಪ್ರಶಾಂತಿ ಡ್ವೆಲರ್ಸ್ ಸಹ ವ್ಯಾಸ ಅಸ್ಮಾನ್ ಜೀವನಧಾರಾಯಾಂ ಪ್ರೇರೆಯತು ಯೋಗಮಾರ್ಗೇ ಇತಿ ಉಕ್ತ್ವಾ ವಿರಮಾಮಿ
ಪ್ರಣಾಮ್ ಸರ್ಜಿ ವಿತ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಮೇ ನೌ ಇನ್ವೈಟ್ ಅವರ್ ವೈಸ್ ಚಾನ್ಸಲರ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ರಾಮಕೃಷ್ಣ ಬಿಹಾರ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್
ಶಂಕರಂ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯಂ ಕೇಶವಂ ಬಾದರಾಯಣಂ ಅಸ್ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಪರ್ಯಂತಂ ವಂದೇ ಗುರು ಪರಂಪರಾಂ ದೀಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ರಿಪೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಸಚ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಸೂಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೇ ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಗುರು ಪೂರ್ಣಿಮಾ in order to lighten the lamp within ourselves by the grace of guru already acharya ji has narrated the role and the importance of guru our respected guru ji nagendra ji is also going to narrate on behalf of all of you I want to do guru pujana right in front of you and wish you all a very happy prosperous positive guru purnima day and let there be a blessing of all gurus so as to become the real ambassadors of yoga not only of yoga even in order to make your journey to reach the ultimate bliss I don't want to take much time, but I will do Guru Pujana on behalf of all of you.
ಪುತ್ರೇತಿ ತನ್ಮಯತೆಯ ತರವೋಭಿನೇತು ಹೂತಂ ಸರ್ವಭೂತ ಹೃದಯಂ ಮುನಿಂ ಆನತೋಸ್ಮಿ
We are so blessed to see such Guru Pujan tradition. Now I would call the YIC student for a Phala Samparnam to the Swamiji. Request our Honorable Guruji, Dr. H.R. Nagendraji, to come on the stage.
Namashri Yatirajaya Vivekananda Suraye Satchit Sukhaswarupaya Swamine Tapaharine Tapaharine Tapaharine. My dear brothers and sisters, on this very auspicious occasion of the Guru Purnima, let us seek the blessings of the Trinity, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Sharadama, and Swami Vivekananda, who are the Trinity Gurus of this institution, and that their guidance, direction, take all of us to build Mother Bharat to its greatest excellence, which can bring peace on earth, harmony and love, universal brotherhood to all the people, to cherish the great goal of Vasudha Eva Kutumbakam. The whole world should become one family, you know. And how can this happen? Swami Vivekananda gave the direction, inspired by Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, having realized the truth, the reality. You have to bring that spiritual wisdom base, that we are not just this physical body, but we have four more bodies, and beyond these five koshas, we have that pure consciousness called Brahman. And that is the one that builds his whole creation. And that is our source, our original home, featured by infinite knowledge, infinite power, infinite freedom, infinite bliss. And therefore, we all have to move towards it. As we move, more and more of the divinity should manifest. Swami Vivekananda said, the goal of life is to manifest the divinity within. How to do that? By controlling nature external, controlling nature internal. Our external behavior and internal transformation to move towards the Daivi Sampath, to reduce the Asuri Sampath and to move towards the Daivi Sampath. Love, compassion, friendship, magnanimity, sharing, control over the senses, all these things should blossom more and more, and the calmness, the peace should all start developing. And how can this happen? By yoga. He said, do it by work or worship, philosophy or psychic control. Karma yoga, Raja yoga, Bhakti yoga, Jnana yoga. By one or more or all of these, and be free, he said. Freedom is our birthright. We must have infinite freedom. Freedom from all our tensions and stresses, diseases, bondages. We must reach that highest goal of human aspiration. So this is the direction given by the Trinity, which essentially is also the message that our ancient scriptures give us. And as rightly our Ramchandra Bhatji mentioned, these are all given right in the beginning of the creation through the Saptarshis and the great Lord, and the Vyasa Maharshi gave it through the Prasthanatraya, Upanishads, the Bhagavad Gita and the Brahma Sutras. That gives the whole knowledge base. And to bring that into action, we have Jnana Yoga, Raja Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga to be brought forth. And therefore, this university is devoted and dedicated to bring this total wisdom base to people all over the world. And yoga as a science of holistic living, not merely as a set of practice of asana, pranayama, mudra, spandas and kriyas alone. It's a process of transformation, cleansing ourselves, purification of ourselves, of the body, of the mind and the emotions and the intellect. Everything has to be purified. Then the tremendous bliss, everything will start manifesting. So on this auspicious day, let us all pray to the great Maharishis, great spiritual saints, great yoga masters in our country to help us to see that we grow gradually, systematically, day by day, weeks after week, months after months, and years after years to do these things. On this auspicious day, I want to place on record the great contributions of many gurus who have been here, who brought this wisdom base into academic excellence. Professor N.V.C. Swami, who was the director of IIT, Chennai, Madras, he came to us, encyclopedia of all Upanishads and the science and spirituality. He was able to direct us to build the entire new syllabus for this university. We all joined together, Ramchandra Bhatji and Professor Satyanarayana Shastriji and Mohan, Subhadra, then we had the Swamiji, everybody sat together, Dr. Nagaratna, and built up the syllabus for that, to set into an academic dimension. There was a big challenge. How to combine the best of the East with the best of the West? Every student should know and learn whatever is there in the subject which has been given by the Western wisdom base. Then we have to expand it further to bring the Eastern wisdom base. Therefore, the student should learn both. Unfortunately, in the whole of our country, our entire education system is only importing the Western knowledge base. And hardly we have been able to touch even a little bit of Indian wisdom base. So this was the challenge. 3 to 4 years we worked to develop this syllabus for the bachelor's degree, the master's degree, and the doctoral program. A simple example, when we want to deal with anatomy, physiology, we said it's about the body. Then we had to build anatomy, physiology of pranayama kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha. Similarly, when we teach quantum mechanics, which is the key essence of the modern physics, then you bring in the dimensions of consciousness. And this is how we built every subject into two dimensions. This is the uniqueness of this university. Many people thought, how can we have a university for yoga? Because their concept of yoga was essentially asanas. Yoga meant asanas, a physical exercise. But the holistic vision of Swami Vivekananda has to be translated into the university. Therefore, yoga and its applications were all brought forth together to build this syllabus. We divided the whole university into 5 divisions. Division of Yoga Spirituality, Division of Yoga and Life Sciences, Division of Yoga and Physical Sciences, Division of Yoga and Management Studies, Division of Yoga and Humanities. In each one of them, bachelor's degree, master's degree and doctoral program were to be done, and we started developing the programs. Initial days were very difficult to have the students, because They did not know what is going to be the scope of joining this university. Do we get a good job after this thing? What we are going to do? Where we are going to be housed? But the continued effort and dedicated efforts of all our teachers, the gurus, made it possible. And now today we have grown to the biggest thing, and it is the only full-fledged yoga university in the country, in the world. And the NAC gave us the highest accreditation of A++. It has gone into category one. So what is the dimension that brought this to this scale? It is to bring the best of the Western wisdom base with the Eastern wisdom base. Modern scientific research among thousands and thousands of yoga institutions all over the world, Svyasa and Vyasa movement hinges itself on the strong foundations of modern scientific research. So we had to build a new laboratory, a research laboratory, which is very unique. We have laboratories to measure various things of the physical body. You know, we have laboratories to measure what is happening in the brain, what is happening in the autonomic nervous system, what is happening in the biochemical parameters, and the genes and the gene sequencing. All these things are done by many, many laboratories in the world and in our country. We have to set them too. But we have to add on the dimensions of the Eastern wisdom base. Can we measure the pranamaya kosha? Can we measure the manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha? This is the direction that we took. Gradually, the technology developed, and with our association with the Russian researchers, the German researchers, and the researchers in the United States, slowly, one by one, the technology started coming up. And today, we are in a fortunate position. We can probably measure everything. We have got the GDV, Echograph, and VPK, Nadi Tharangani, several things to measure at the Pranamaya Kosha. Then we have Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, Anandamaya Kosha. Everything can be measured. And that is the uniqueness of this Anveshna labs that we have set up. And when people come from different parts of the world, different laboratories, different universities, they find this something very unique. And that is what we have been able to achieve here. And I place on record the wonderful contributions of large number of our gurus who made this possible. Researchers and teachers, faculties, assistant professors, associate professors, professors, everybody worked on this thing to make this possible. And we are growing more and more. Using this, we have to bring good research papers. Then only the world will accept us. Therefore, we started doing research way back in 1975-78, and our first paper that was brought for British Medical Journal, that spread our entire message throughout the world. One single paper, Yoga for Bronchial Asthma, spread our entire work throughout the world. What type of yoga can we use for asthma? Can we come and learn from you? Can you people come and teach us? Can we have collaborative research? The best of the research institutions in the world called us to have collaboration. This is how we spread the whole dimension of things. And this is how we grow systematically. And as you know, today we have the largest number of research papers in the world in the field of yoga. And a time has come that we had to bring it to benefit everybody in the society. Our Prime Minister made this grow great throughout the world. 1893, September 11, 9/11/1893, was a day when India rose to great heights by the wonderful Chicago address of Swami Vivekananda in the Parliament of Religions. The spirituality message to bring universal brotherhood, peace on earth, was spread throughout the world by one single talk by him. Then came another Narendra few years back, and he was able to again give a talk which mesmerized the whole world, and 184 countries, including 45 Islamic countries, also came forward to support and approve the suggestion that June 21st should be the International Day of Yoga. So two Narendras did that, you know, and yoga started spreading all over. But the vision of our Prime Minister was very clear. It should not just be one day celebration, but it should go into our entire education system, and it should go into our entire health system. It should become part of our entire life. So he called meetings of all the ministries and pushed them. Yes, everybody should use yoga, whether it's Navy, Air Force, or Army, or whether it's Border Security Forces, or in management sectors, scientific circles, health sectors, all ministries. He called again and again. I remember 2014, he had almost 8 wonderful meetings, and he said yoga should be brought. Everybody should do. And nearly 5 crores of practice, people practice this wonderful protocol that we developed. That protocol everybody should study, 35 minutes protocol, very intelligently done, including all the 4 streams of yoga, Jnana Yoga, Raja Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga. You have to decipher that, you know. How was this done? With the help of all the yoga masters in the country, we had meetings to achieve this thing. Then came the syllabus to be brought for the NCTE, NCERT, UGC, the entire education system. And then yoga to be brought forth into the medical community, and slowly we started developing and bringing. And the premier institute of health, R&D Institute of Medical Sciences in Delhi, said that yes, we have to bring in yoga. Now, in every department of AIIMS, the research project is going on yoga. 24 research projects going on. Then looking at it, the Chandigarh, PGI is coming up, the AIIMS in Rishikesh is coming up, and several other things. The government, hospitals and institutions have started bringing yoga. And it has to be brought into education system, the medical education. Therefore, the latest thing is that yoga should be brought into all medical education, think in the AYUSH system and also in the allopathic system, whether it is MBBS or MD, whether it is the mental health programs, or here in AYUSH, you know, Ayurveda, Yoga, Naturopathy, Siddha, Yunani, Homeopathy, Sovarishta. In all these places, yoga should form the base. That has been the direction given. And Niti Aayog, which is the counterpart of Planning Commission, is coming forward. Therefore, India is embellishing this entire dimension of bringing yoga to health sector and the education sector. Similarly, in all the engineering and the technological institutes, yoga is becoming a common factor. In the management scenario, it is shaping up. And the vision of our Prime Minister to see that it should go into every sector through the education system, health section, and other dimension. And this is the right opportunity for all of us to spread this into every nook and corner. And the whole world is ready, looking at India, because the matter-based paradigm featured by Artha and Kama has not given us the solutions. It has brought more and more challenges, challenges of addictions, depressions, anxieties, and single parent problems, and large number of these modern NCDs have thrown such challenges, multi-dimensional challenges, for which the modern medical system or the modern science has no solution. Therefore, the best of the scientists, the Nobel laureates, are all looking to India to give a solution. And it's our ardent duty to see that this total wisdom base of India should be brought to the forefront to all these sectors and see that it grows. And that is a great job that this university will do. And the Ministry of HRD, realizing this need, has opened up a new institution, a central government institution, Inter-University Center for Yoga Sciences. And this IUCYS is going to bring a standardization throughout the country for the yoga programs and all over the world. Accreditation is done in our country by the NAC, National Assessment and Accreditation Council, and this is going to lead the accreditation of higher education yoga throughout the world. And we had a wonderful global summit in UNO New York, and large number of these people, accreditation experts came together, they have all accepted. And therefore, it is not too far before the NAC takes the lead, India takes the lead to bring standardization and accreditation of the yoga in the higher education throughout the world, whether it's in Japan or whether it's in the United States, whether in Singapore, in all places where yoga is shaping up into the higher education system, the accreditation process will be led by India. That is the greatest contribution of our present government and particularly our Prime Minister. And therefore, we are very, very indebted to him to launch this great revolution. And we are moving from industrial revolution to yoga revolution. A revolution of yoga is coming up throughout the world, and we are all ambassadors of this great revolution that is coming up. In the beginning, when industrial revolution took place, all the best of the minds, intellectuals all over the world, you know, joined together to build this industrial revolution into the scientific paradigm of the matter-based paradigm. But now, a new revolution is coming with yoga at the base to move towards the consciousness-based paradigm. That consciousness is primary and matter in the end product. And therefore, on this very auspicious day, let us all commit ourselves, dedicate ourselves, and put all our tan, man, dhan to see that we bring this spiritual wisdom base, the consciousness-based paradigm, to the world at large. And that is the great message that we take today from the great masters, Swami Vivekananda, Sri Aurobindo, Swami Shivananda, and all the yoga masters in the country who have joined together synergetically to form an institution called Indian Yoga Association. And that is going to be our technical advisor for all these dimensions in the field of yoga. With this, once again, I place on record our grateful thanks to all our gurus who made this institution grow to these great heights, and also to all the students and our alumni who have been able to bring this wisdom base to more and more people by bringing this total wisdom base of the holistic vision of yoga to people at large. Similarly, I'm sure all of you who are getting trained here and undergoing these things as alumni is going to spread this holistic vision of yoga to everyone whom you meet today, and more people should participate in the International Day of Yoga next year. And this year our target was 40 crores of people in India and 200 countries, and more or less it has been achieved. Next year our target is to bring nearly 50 to 60 crores of people to participate in the International Day of Yoga in next year. That all depends on all of you. Therefore, each one of you should inspire people and teach people to learn this protocol of 35 minutes plus elective another 10 minutes to see that everybody learns and practices and see that. What is the purpose? To prevent diseases, to promote positive health, and to move towards happy life. And that is the need of the hour, to build the whole family as one whole. So big scaled up programs of the diabetes control program has been achieved, and the American Diabetic Association has applauded this and gave a big award for this NMB, Niyantrita Madhumeha Bharat. Now we are taking up the cancer control program, integrated cancer program, and that is going to be done in 100 districts in the country. 2 crore people will be screened, and I recently met the ministers. They are all very eager. Yes, we have to take this and we have to give the lead, and therefore we are ahead to see that we even start controlling, preventing cancer, and to promote yoga dimension into the field of cancer. These are the most dreaded diseases. And on this very auspicious day, let us pray to Maharshi Vyasa Maharshi and all the Saptarishis, Swami Vivekananda, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, and Sharadama, to give us the strength to see that all of us will dedicate ourselves to change ourselves, transform ourselves, to become wonderful promoters and ambassadors of this Daivi Sampat, and bring that blissful awareness to everybody, health, happiness to everyone. And I wish you all the best. Thank you all.
Pranam Guruji. With this wonderful insight, we are all blessed to be on this wonderful occasions of Guru Purnima. Let's have a huge round of applause for all our dignitaries present here today. Arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached. we are obliged to dedicate this wonderful prayer to our gurus all around the world who have taught us, shaped us, and carved us to be who we are. I request all of you to please stand up for Guru Prarthana, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, followed by Aarti and Shanti Mantra.
Let us all just recite the Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu together, please. Let's start.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwarah, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
Thank you all. Please sit down.
Aarti.
Okay. Oh, please stand up. Stand up for the aarti, please.
Jo dadhati.